Toxoplasma gondii. Toxoplasma gondii is an obligate intracellular parasite of the villi apicomplexa. When Toxoplasma gondii infects humans, the disease is called toxoplasmosis. Groups at risk of toxoplasmosis include pregnant women and infants born to infected mothers, and immunocompromised individuals, including those with HIV, blood or organ transfusions, and those under immunosuppression therapy. Toxoplasma gondii is found worldwide. Seroprevalence rate range from less than 10% to over 60%, depending on the rate of case report, host susceptibility, dietary habits, hygiene, and sanitation. Transmission of Toxoplasma gondii may occur through three infectious stages. Sporozoites in sporulated oocytes that can be transmitted through ingestion of contaminated food and water. Tachyzoites in blood circulation that can be transmitted through fetal maternal circulation or blood transfusion. And bradyzoites in host tissue that can be transmitted through ingestion of infected meat or organ transplant. Cats are the definitive host of Toxoplasma gondii. Inside the cat's intestines, male and female gametes of Toxoplasma gondii mate to form the oocysts. And these oocysts are shed along with the cat's feces. Within 1 to 5 days, the oocysts will be matured and sporulated and are infective to the host. These mature oocysts may be ingested by bigger mammals such as sheep and pigs and develop into bradyzoites in their muscles. Infective oocysts may also contaminate fruits, vegetables, and water. Humans may be infected through ingestion of undercooked meat or contaminated food or water, and that the infections may manifest in human brain, eye, heart, or in case of pregnancies in developing fetus. Rats are also able to ingest the mature oocysts. And when cats prey on these rats, the infection cycles continues. Human toxoplasmosis can occur in various forms. Asymptomatic, that accounts for approximately 80% of cases. Congenital toxoplasmosis, toxoplasmic chorioretinitis, toxoplasmic encephalitis, and, all too uncommon, pulmonary toxoplasmosis. Diagnostic strategies for human toxoplasmosis can be adjusted according to the clinical setting and the patient's immune condition. These include careful history taking and physical examination, particularly to obtain information regarding patient's risk factors and clinical signs and symptoms. This should be confirmed by performing supporting diagnostic tests using appropriate clinical specimens, such as Toxoplasma serology. This should be confirmed by performing supporting diagnostic tests using appropriate clinical specimens, such as Toxoplasma serology using ELISA, to acquire information regarding the stage of infection, whether the infection is acute or has occurred in the past. Imaging studies, mainly to evaluate localized disease in the brain or other organs, and microscopic detection of the parasite in host tissue or other specimens, such as brain or muscle biopsy. Although the method is not always easy to perform, microscopic detection remains the gold standard of diagnosis of human toxoplasmosis. This can be achieved by the detection of infective stages such as oocysts, tachyzoites, and bradyzoites. The first infective stage that can be detected is the oocysts. Oocysts is excreted in cat's feces in unsporulated form. The shape is spherical to subspherical with varying sizes. Unsporulated oocysts become sporulated and infectious within 1 to 5 days in soil or water. Sporulated oocysts contains 2 sporocysts with 4 sporozoites each. The sporulated or mature oocyst is the infective stage to rodents, mammals, and humans. The next infective stage that can be detected is the tachyzoite. Tachyzoite is the active form of Toxoplasma gondii as it actively multiplies in intestinal cells of cats or in any cells of rodents, mammals, and humans. Tachyzoite is crescent-shaped with characteristic apical structure called ticonoid that plays a role in parasite invasion to target cells. These tachyzoites can be identified from blood or bone marrow smears. The third infective stage that can be detected is the bradyzoite. When the parasite senses danger from either unsuitable environmental conditions or the presence of immune cells, tachyzoite enseas itself into bradyzoites in tissues. Bradyzoite is the slow-growing form of Toxoplasma gondii. Bradyzoites can be identified from tissue biopsies, commonly from muscle and brain tissues.